Hello everyone, I am Samuel, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, and I am handling Computer Architecture and Organization. Today we are going to see a very important concept in the Computer Architecture and Organization. Hope you will enjoy the video. Thank you. We are going to see what is a bus in a computer and also what is the structure of the bus in a computer. Now, what is a bus? If you take the real-time example, we use the bus as one of the modes of the transport to travel from one place to another place, from source to destination. So same like that, a bus in a computer is used to transfer the data from source to destination. So we are going to see what is a bus and what are the types of buses available, and also what is the structure of the bus. What is a bus? A bus is a communication pathway connecting two or more devices. A bus is a communication pathway. It is a pathway to communicate data or to communicate a device that is more than one device. That can be it has to be one or two or more devices. So it is a communication pathway. The key characteristic of a bus is that in a computer is that it is not only a communication pathway, it also acts as a medium. It acts as a shared transmission medium. And a bus consists of multiple pathway R lines. Or in other words, you can say, if the bus contains more than 150 to 50 lines, then you can say it is a bus. A bus consists of multiple pathway R lines. Each line is capable of transmitting signals representing binary digit one and so on. So it's in a computer, everything, the signals, the data will be transmitted only in binary digits 1 or 0. So a bus is a communication pathway that is used to connect two or more devices. Now, what are those devices? That depends upon the user. One uses the computer or one uses the system. Now we will see. So we have seen about a bus is a communication pathway, and also it is a shared transmission medium. Several lines can be used to transmit bits simultaneously. That is, we can transmit n number of bits parallelly. A bus that connects major components, we have already seen about the previous video, the components of the computer, the memory, the I/O and the CPU. So, and also the connection of these components or connecting these components are called as interconnection structure that we have previously seen. Here, the connection of if a communication pathway that connects these three major components are called as, or it is called as system bus. Seen that a bus consists of multiple pathway R lines. A system bus consists at least 50 to 100 lines, and each line is assigned a particular meaning or a function. Each line, the 50 to 100 lines, each line is assigned a particular meaning. And on any bus, the lines can be classified into three groups. There are three groups in a bus, in a bus line. The first one is the address line. The second one is the data lines, the control lines. Or in other words, we can say address bus, a data bus, and the control bus. Now, in the upcoming slides, we will see about what is address bus, what is the data bus, and what is a control bus. Typically called as address bus. And the main operation of a address bus or address line, it is used to designate the source or destination of the data on the data bus. The main aspect of or the main operation of the address line or address bus, which is used to point out the location, where is the data in the data bus or where is the data in the memory location. For example, in a memory, we have data on, for example, a 10th line, or in the data is located on a 10th segment or a 10th page, means the address bus will designate or will point out the location where the data is on the memory or on the data bus. And the another important aspect is we have to learn about, that is address line or address bus is a unidirectional. It is a one way. It only designates the data. It will not fetch the data from the memory or fetch the data from the data bus. The address line is used to designate the data, and also and it is unidirectional. This pathway is unidirectional only. The width of the address bus determines the maximum possible memory capacity of the system. So the width of the address bus determines the capacity of the system. Now we will see what is mean by, or what is the use of, or what is the operation of an address bus or address line. Next we will see about the data bus or the data line. These lines, the data lines, are collectively are called as data bus. It provides a path for moving the data from system modules. So the address bus is used to designate the data, whereas the data bus, it is used to fetch the data from the preferred module. It provides a pathway for moving the data from one place to another place, whereas the address bus is used as a one-way direction. It is a unidirectional. It is used to designate the source as the destination, whereas the data bus will fetch the data where the address bus provided the source or destination, or it has designated the address, the source, or the destination. So the data line or a data bus is a bidirectional. The address bus is a unidirectional. Next we will see about the control bus or the control lines. The address line is this. The address line or the control line or the control bus is used to control the access of the data and the address bus, or you can say the address bus and the data bus. So a control line or a control bus, it is controls the access of the use, and what is the use of this, and what is the use of address bus, what is the operation of the address bus, what is the operation of the data bus. So the control line controls the access of these bus, and it includes some operations. The control bus includes some operations. It has a memory write, it has a memory read, it has IO read and write, so on. So it has interrupt request also. Sometimes some devices might give an interrupt signal for the in order to access the address bus or the data bus. So this is about the bus interconnection. The summary of this video is that the address bus is used to designate the data, designate the source or the destination, and it is a unidirectional. Whereas the data line or the data bus, it is used to fetch the data, and it acts, and it has a bidirectional pathway. The third one is the control bus, which is used to control the access of the data and the address bus. Thank you. Thank you.